Hey yo, what's going on peeps? It's your boy back at it again, and welcome back to Breaking Bad Tuesday. That's right, every single day I'm gonna try and make the Breaking Bad videos on like every Tuesday pretty much, you know? And today we're gonna be checking out the funniest Breaking Bad moments in the series, and I'm excited to check these out. I need a good laugh, that's for sure. And look, there's a lot of Breaking Bad funny moments, but unfortunately I won't be able to cover every single one of them. But if this video gets to 1,000 views, your boy will do like a part two. Let's get down to business. So up first, you can't have a Breaking Bad funny moments compilation without, you know, Skyler confronting Jesse, you know? So yeah, we're gonna give this another look. This is one of my favorite scenes. I love it.
Excuse me? You? Yes, you. May I talk to you?
Oh yeah, he was like kind of trying to hide a body during this time.
Whoa, hey, this is private property.
Just a minute, I want to talk to you.
No, not interested, come on.
Hey, don't touch me. Do not touch me.
All right, look, not touching, okay? Not touching here. Look, lady, whatever you're selling, I ain't buying.
Yeah, right there.
Well, my name is Skyler White.
White, yo.
My husband is Walter White. Yo. He told me everything.
Seriously?
That's right. And just so you know, my brother-in-law is a
DEA agent.
And I will not hesitate to call him, not if I have to. Understood? This is your one and only warning. Do not sell marijuana to my husband.
Okay.
I mean it. Don't call our house
again. That must have been a relief for Jesse,
you
bro.
Stay
like,
away from
imagine.
Him, or you will be one sorry individual.
I think so, yeah. No more marijuana. I can dig it.
Amazing scene. Just amazing. Everything about that was just so meme-worthy, bro. There's a reason this became a big, like, TikTok trend for a few days, bro. I love this, bro. Like, she tries to act all gangster and use gangster terms like, yo. So fun to laugh at, that's for sure. Up next, we got ourselves... Do I even need to explain myself? F you in your eyebrows. I think this is talking to Bolsa or something. So let's check it out. He does have some crazy eyebrows, though, that's for sure. Like, what the hell are those, man?
Walter, come on, man. I'm short-handed. I need you outside to do some wipe downs. Come on.
What?
I said I need you outside to do some wipe downs. Are you here to work or to be staring at the skies? Come on. Let's go. Come on, man.
Fuck you, Bunda. I said fuck you and your eyebrows.
Look at those things, bro. Just look at those. Why are they so bushy? Like, dog. He lost in the genetics race, that's for sure, bro. Ooh. All right, up next, we got Jesse making fun of Walt's tidy whiteys. I'm pretty sure this is when they're in the desert and they're kind of stranded, I believe. Yeah. And he's just wearing the most baggy clothing.
These are my good clothes. Can't go home smelling like a meth lab.
Yeah, you can. I do. Those? Wow. Those, you're keeping those on, right?
Alright, well, there was a point that he didn't, you know?
Daylight's burning.
Is Ro gonna record him? Oh my god.
This is a good look for you. And you're maybe only the world's second biggest homo.
You shut up and help me.
I forgot he said that.
Yeah.
That was crazy.
Oh yeah. Work it, baby. Work it.
Hey, yo! Oh, shoot. That was very interesting, that's for sure. All right, so up next, we got Walt winning a fight for once. Let's go. And it's pretty much him standing up for his son at a clothing store, so.
Are you sure you don't want to get the, like, a different kind? Like, the skinny jeans? Because those are really supposed to be in style now. The skaters wear them.
Do I look like a skater?
No, you don't.
My big boy pants.
Oh, they're such jerks, bro. Oh, there's...
Mama, could you zip up my big boy pants?
Oh, they're dead, man. They're dead.
God.
Walt. They're obviously very stupid.
Oh, yeah, they are.
You know what? Why don't you just hang out here for a second? I'll be right back.
Oh, no. Hey, mommy.
Oh, boy, here we go.
Loaf in my brand new big boy pants.
Here he goes.
What are you doing?
What's wrong, Chief? Having a little trouble walking?
Very Sigma moment for Walt.
Get off me! Get off me! I'll mess you up, man.
Well, you'll have one shot. You better make it good.
Bro,
what
look how his
you
face changes.
You better go. You better go. Take it. Take your shot.
Nah, bro, he made him look like a... Look at that! Look at that, bro! He looks like a baby! Bro was talking so much crap, and now he just looks like he's gonna cry, man! God dang, Walt! You really humble that kid! Okay, up next, we got... I believe this is Jesse Pinkman ringtone, pretty much. Or answering machine. I don't know why this is so low quality, but.
Yo, 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 148, 3 to the 3 to the 6 to the 9, representing the ABQ. What up, biatch? Leave it tone.
Yeah, and that's when Skylar starts to get a bit suspicious, you know? Right up next, we got Crazy 8 and Walter. Oh, yeah. That's when he walked out like a literal zombie. Like, bro, he looks like aliens, a walking dead. That's so weird, bro. Like, I'd be so confused, man.
Hey, listen. No.
The girl is running for his life. And then, now he's for sure dead now. Yeah, and then after that, you know what he does? He pretty much destroys all evidence. Oof, that's something. All right, up next we got, climb out of my ass. That's a crazy quote from Walt, bro.
What I need is for you to climb down out of my ass.
Me trying to get anyone out of my business, bro.
Can you do that?
Oh, man.
Will you do that for me, honey? Will you please, just once, get off my ass? I'd appreciate it. I really would.
That smile, bro. God dang it, Walt. They wanted to make him look like a villain, bro. He looks too funny for a villain, bro. I don't know. All right, so up next, we got Talking Pillow, the intervention scene. All right, let's see.
At all! Courtesy of giving you my honest opinion.
You know, Marie, this is not debate club. This is my husband's life.
You know,
we're talking about
one.
Here.
This is my husband's life we're talking about.
Small
and
thing.
It's like,
ladies, come
on. How dare you? Somebody who disagrees with you.
Oh, geez.
This is so stupid.
I agree.
All right, I've got the talking pillow now, okay?
All right, let him cook. All right, so that was kind of the only funny part of this scene. The other stuff is kind of sad. All right, everybody. Up next, we got, yeah, Mr. White.
Bill by the
4 pounds. 4 pounds. 2 pounds wasn't bad enough. We're talking 200-300 boxes of sinus pills. There ain't that many smurfs in the world.
We're not going to need pseudoephedrine. We're going to make phenylacetone in a tube furnace. Then we're going to use reductive amination to yield methamphetamine. 4 pounds.
So no pseudo?
No pseudo.
So you do have a plan. Yeah, Mr. White. Yes, science.
Man, Jesse, if only didn't drop out, maybe you'd know a few things about science.
What's this?
That is a shopping list. Getting some of those items may be challenging.
One auto transformer, 6 liters, and hydrous methamine.
Oh my
235 M&M tube furnaces.
It's millimeter. 170 millimeter would be fine, but they're hard to come by.
40 grams thorium nitrate. Yo, Mr. White, I can't even pronounce half this shit.
No, you know what? Count me out. All right, I'm leaving town. I'm moving to like Oregon or something. This is
Jesse, listen. Today is the first day of the rest of your life.
Oh, yeah, that was pretty funny for the most part. Yeah, I like that. Okay, so up next we got Hector Salamanca pooping himself. Yeah, basically. So,
come on, granddad, don't you want to help us out?
Bro, he ain't no snitch. Bro, what? Wait. Oh god, that was disgusting. Oh, who put those sound effects in? You're crazy. What the hell? Oh, that was disgusting. We got the first appearance of Saul Goodman. Oh, what the hell?
You just tell me your supplier is. This can end very well for you.
What are you doing, detective?
Oh, shoot!
My client without me present. You sneaky Pete. What did the academy hire you right out of the womb? You guys get younger every...
Bro, I'm watching Better Call Saul right now, and let me tell you, bro. Good show.
What'd you say to Babyface, huh? Didn't you say anything stupid? By anything stupid, I mean anything at all. Oh, look at you, mouth open, vocal cords of Twitter. We'll talk about it later. Right now, you out. Go on. There are laws, detective. Have your kindergarten teacher read them to you, right? Go grab a juice box. Have a nap. Go on. Who do we have?
Brandon Mayhew.
The goat has arrived, bro.
Ah, here we go. Public masturbation.
What?
I can get it. What's the kick? Why don't you do it at home like the rest of us with a big flat screen TV, 50 channels of pay-per-view, in a Starbucks. That's nice.
That ain't me, man.
Does Kim know about that, Saul? Or, I mean, I haven't gotten to the end of the season, so I don't know what happens, but...
I was the guy who was selling meth, allegedly.
Okay, all right, I got you. Meth. Felony quantity.
Just barely.
Yeah, just barely. Cops around here are like butchers. punchers always got their thumbs on the scale. I'll be good luck arguing that in court. Let me get down to brass tacks. I'm going to get you a second phone call, okay? You're going to call your mommy or your daddy or your parish priest or your Boy Scout leader, and they're going to deliver me a check for $4,650. I'm going to write that down on the back of my business card. 4650, okay? And I need that in the cashier's check. And make it out to Ice Station Zebra Associates. That's my loan out. It's totally legit. It's done just for tax purposes. And after that, we can discuss Visa or MasterCard, but definitely not American Express. So don't even ask, all right? Any questions?
Yeah, as I said, bro, I'm watching Better Call Saul right now, and I'm curious to see how it all goes up to this point, because currently they're in the past. Just got to the end of season 3. This is pretty cool to look back at now. All right, speaking of more Saul, we get Saul meeting Walter for the first time. All right.
Mayhew. Nice of you to come down. Should I call the FBI and tell them I found D.B. Cooper? Joking. Saul Goodman. So it's a shame that we have to meet under these circumstances. I believe you have something for me. Mayhew, is that Irish or English?
Irish.
Faith in Begorra, a fellow potato eater. My real name's McGill. The Jew thing I just do for the homeboys. They all
want
a pipe member of the tribe, so to speak. Fact is, your nephew is going to get out in no time.
That's wonderful.
There's still a few details to be ironed out, but now that the DEA is involved, I think he's looking at time served and probation. Leave your number with Francesca, and we'll be in touch.
Excuse me, the DEA?
Yeah, that's the Drug Enforcement Administration, the feds.
Oh, you know how that, you know how bad that is for Walter, bro.
Your nephew got mixed up with some pretty nasty customers.
I understand that, but what does that have to do with the DEA?
They're after some mystery man, some heavy hitter. It goes by the name Heisenberg. They want this guy like the axe wants the turkey. Seems young Brandon may have some information that could lead to his arrest. And this is good news. I mean, Brandon fell headfirst into the doo-doo pile and came up smelling like Paco Rabanne.
I just think that we should view our options.
Options? I'm going to tell you what your options are, okay? And you got a grand total of 2. Option A, Brandon takes the deal. Option B, Brandon goes up to the penitentiary and gets his rectum resized about yay big.
Oh, my God.
What about prices? I mean, if Brandon informs on this Heisenberg, what if, God forbid, that they decide to take revenge?
The kid keeps spouting off about it. If I talk, they'll kill me, blah, blah, blah. You know, right now, he's the only thing holding up this deal. No, that's not good. That's terrible. Trust me, sir, your nephew won't last in prison 2 weeks, right? You let him take his chances on the
game. One of them killed another man by crushing his head with an ATM machine.
I wonder who that was.
People love to take credit for the fun ones.
$10,000.
That's mad.
Cash to you. Not saying to throw the case.
Are you saying what I think you're saying?
Yes. What's it going to be?
Now that was the start of a good friendship for a while. Oh yeah. Okay. And the next funny moment, I guess, at that time. Threatening Saul.
Badger Mayhew, the best legal representation ever. But no deals with the DEA. All right? Badger will not identify anyone to anybody. If he does, you're dead.
Why don't you just kill Badger?
Well,
I mean, follow me, guys, but mosquitoes buzzing around you bite you on the ass. You don't go gunning for the mosquito's attorney. You go grab a fly swatter, I mean, so to speak. I mean, all due respect, do I have to spell this out for you?
We're not killing Badger, yo!
Then you got real problems, okay? Because the DEA Badger, is going to come down on your boy like a proverbial ton of bricks. Hey, he's not going to like prison. He's going to sing like Celine Dion, regardless of what you do to me.
Uh-oh, Walt, expose your cover, Walt.
Mr. Mayhew, recognize your cough. Take that mask off, you know, get some air. One. God, take it easy. All right, I'm gonna stand up, all right? Because I got bad knees. Okay, now listen, the three of us are gonna work this out. Yeah? First things first, you're gonna put a dollar in my pocket, both of you. You want attorney-client privilege, don't you? So that everything you say is strictly between us. Put a dollar in my pocket. Come on, make it official. All right, now you, ski bum. Come on, give with the dollar.
All I got's a five.
I'll take a five. Come on already, come on. Okay, you're now both officially represented by Saul Goodman and Associates. Hey. Your secrets are safe with me. Take the ski mask off. I feel like I'm talking to the weather underground here. Okay, so if a prison shanking is completely off the table, and we're sure of that?
No shanking!
Right, all right. And the way I see it is, somebody's going to prison.
Oh, yeah, and that's where, you know, they bring in the decoy, pretty much. That's a pretty funny shot, yeah. All right, and now we get Jesse Pinkman being like, yes, hell yeah. Pounds. Oh, look at all that.
19.
Dollar-wise, how much?
Well, median weight, 2.2 pounds. That's 41.8, call it 42 pounds. At what are we selling for these days?
40 a pound.
$40,000.
And you said raise the prices.
$672,000.
All in.
Damn.
Each.
That's a lot of money.
Yes! Hell yeah! Hey, come on, baby! Come on! Yes! Come on!
Yeah!
Yes! Yes!
Yo, that's hype, bro. Rare bro moment from them, man. All right, up next, we got Breaking Bad and a robot.
What are you building?
Set it yourself.
Robot?
Battery.
Move!
All right. Okay, I had, like, no context to that, but yeah, that was pretty funny. Okay, up next, we got the wire scene. What is this?
Good, and what shall we use to conduct this beautiful current? What? One particular element.
Wire.
Wire. Oh, that's where it's from.
Copper.
I've heard that sound bit so many times. That's where it's from. Okay. Okay, up next we got Skyler There's Rot. Yeah, it looks totally normal, Walt. That didn't sound good. Completely normal dinner.
Are you going to work today?
Skyler There's Rot.
Whoa! Well, bro, whoever edited this is mad. What the hell?
Rot.
Bro, like,
going back.
Bro, whoever edited this was horny. All right, now we get Walt from Walter Jr. or Finn, whatever you want to call him. Why you gotta be such a B?
I know it's because you told him not to. But I don't know what your problem is. You may not love him anymore, but I do.
Hey.
I mean, why you gotta be such a bitch? Hey, no.
Your own son. Oh man, imagine that, man. All right, and now we got one of the most goated scenes of the entire show.
Pizza on the roof.
Look at him. He's such a nice guy.
Pizza.
Yeah. Well, I'm making dinner.
Okay.
I take the breadsticks, though.
Put it in the fridge. It's even better the next day.
Hi, honey.
He was just trying to get his family back together, man.
Skyler, I mean, what kind of example do you want to set here, right? I mean,
we have discussed everything we need to discuss. I thought I made myself very clear.
You got dipping sticks.
Oh, that sucks, man. Oh, here it comes. Here it comes. Yes, yes, yes. Do it. He got it first try, by the way, bro. Oh man, the pizza. No. Oh man, I love that scene so much. Okay, so the last scene I got for y'all is Restrain This. Oh, what the hell?
When I went out this morning to get the newspaper, I saw a
pizza on the roof.
You know about that? Listen to me, Walt. Accept the situation and keep your distance. I will get a restraining order.
Oh, damn. Oh, that's gotta hurt.
It's gotta get your restraining order right here. Restrain it.
Bro really said restrain these nuts, bro. That's crazy. Anyway, folks, that was a lot of fun, you know? We got to see like 20 funny moments from Breaking Bad. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this style of video once again. All my other Breaking Bad videos have done pretty dang well for the channel. So I'm excited to keep making these, and I hope y'all will leave a like and maybe we'll get like a part two of this, man. That'd be pretty lit. So I'll see y'all next time. Peace.